What I'm asking you, Senator, is what is your position on late-term abortion or last trimester abortions?
Well, thank you for serving our community and helping our babies, particularly our preemies, who deeply need the medical care they have. My view on women's reproductive freedom is that it should be a woman's decision to make these most intimate life and death decisions for themselves. A woman should be able to decide when she's having children, how many children she's having, and under what circumstances she's having. And what we have created, unfortunately, is a false choice and a false narrative. And Chris, I want to talk about the role that Fox News plays in this, because it's a problem. I can tell you, before President Trump gave his State of the Union, Fox News talked about infanticide. Infanticide doesn't exist.
Senator, I just want to say, we brought you here for hour. We have given you, we're treating you very fairly. I understand that maybe to make your credentials with the Democrats who are not appearing on Fox News, you want to attack us. I'm not sure it's, frankly, very polite when we've invited you to be here.
I will do it in a polite way, but it's to her
Well,
point.
I just think, why don't we, instead of talking about Fox News, why don't you answer Susan's question?
The debate about whether or not women should have reproductive freedom has turned into a red herring debate. And what happens on Fox News is relevant because they talked about infanticide for 6.5 hours, right before President Trump's State of the Union, mentioned it 35 times. That is not the debate of what access to reproductive care is in this country. It doesn't happen. It's illegal. It's not a fact. And I believe all of us have a responsibility to talk about the facts. The facts are that women in this country have had a constitutional right for over 30 years to make this fundamental life and death decision. And this president has emboldened legislatures in 30 states to begin to criminalize that decision. Criminalize the decision of whether or not and when you want to have your children. Criminalizing the doctors with a 99-year sentence if they are offering abortion services and providing the care that women need. Why should male legislatures across this country decide when you're having children, how many your children you're having, and under what circumstances? I don't understand it. It's a human right. It's about having bodily autonomy. It's about being able to control your physical self. It's undermining every human right, civil right that we could have. So let women make these most personal decisions. For many people, it's a moral decision. For many people, it's a medical decision. So why can't they make it with their doctor, with their families, with their husband, based on their own faith, how they believe and what they feel? It is that woman's right.